everyone. Glad you're with us today. My name is Adria, and I have joining me here in Nairobi, Kenya, my friend David, who is originally from Congo but is studying here in Kenya, and my friend Joe, who is originally from America but is a teacher here in Nairobi, Kenya. So we're glad you're with us. Today we're going to be singing four songs. We're going to be singing Reckless Love, Be Thou My Vision, New Wine, and Love Came Down. And these four songs are from the passage Proverbs 3, 5 through 10 that Pastor Jacob is speaking on today. I wanted to just share with you a little bit about this passage and the reasoning behind these song choices. So, Proverbs 3, verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and we can all finish it, and he will make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones. Honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruits of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. So in this passage, it talks about trusting in the Lord with all of our heart, and don't lean on our own understanding, which is talking about not trying to do it in our own strength, not trying to do it with what we know how to do, but by delighting ourselves in the Lord. And when we delight ourselves in the Lord, when we choose his way over ours, then his desires become our desires, and we ultimately receive the desires of our heart, because our desires are his desires. And then it goes on to say that when you give the first fruits of your crops, of your whatever you have, then the first fruits is the top, the best, not the last, the least, but the finest part of whatever you have, whether that is your heart, your mind, your talent, your profession, your family, whatever it is, to give that to the Lord first as an offering. And then this passage goes on to say that the barns that we have, or our pantries, our refrigerators, whatever it is, will be filled to overflowing, and the vats will brim over with new wine. And wine in biblical times was taken medicinally. It was taken very often, every day, people would drink wine, and it wasn't something that was as readily abused as it is today. Even Jesus took wine. So the song New Wine that Hillsong sings is talking about the process of making wine from grapes. So you think about a grape, and then you think about a glass of wine, and they look completely different, right? And so a grape has to be pressed and crushed and stamped and go through this real tedious process to become the wine. And sometimes when we trust in the Lord and we seek him first, the blessing doesn't always come in a full pantry, or in a full heart, or in a family that's intact, but it comes in the pressing and the crushing, and he does a new thing by creating us into a new creature, and he's given us that grace to become new and to become different than we were. And that hurts sometimes. Actually, all the time it hurts. It hurts a lot. And yet we know that God is faithful and his word rings true. And just this verse 12, I'm just looking at it. It says, "My son, do not despise the Lord's discipline. Do not resent his rebuke. Because the Lord disciplines those he loves, as a father the son he delights in." And a good father would not let his son do something that would hurt him. And he would say, "No, my son, do it this way, do it differently." And that discipline can hurt, but it is profitable, and he brings us into new life with him. So as we sing these songs, think about that his love guides us and leads us and hunts us down and has come down to us in a way that we can understand through Jesus and through his word and through community, through people around us. So in this time when we are separated from others and yet we need each other even more, be so aware that God is with you and he is loving you and with you in the pressing and the crushing. And he will make something beautiful out of you in this time.